In this video, we will discuss the remaining chemical properties of alkanes. First, we will take halogenation. Halogenation is the reaction between alkanes and halogen. For example, you take CH4, methane. Here, this hydrogen of methane is removed and it is substituted with X, that is halogen. So, halogen, we can take chlorine, Cl2, Br2, bromine and I2, iodine. F2, fluorine, we have not taken because the reaction of fluorine with the alkane is highly vigorous due to its small size. Fluorine small size, it will react with alkane very vigorously. So, sometimes explosion will take place. Here, the rate of the reactivity when you talk about chlorine is very fast. Then comes bromine, then comes iodine. So, the rate of the reactivity is chlorination is very fast with alkane, then comes bromination, then comes iodination. So, the iodination of alkane is very slow due to very large size of the iodine. So, this is about the rate of the reactivity. Then we'll go to halogenation reaction, we'll take chlorination. So, you take RH is the general formula for alkane, it reacts with chlorine, Cl2. So, in the presence of sunlight, UV light or heat, there is a removal of hydrogen chloride. So, the remaining what you are getting is RCl. So, RCl is nothing but called as alkyl chloride and hydrogen chloride. So, this is the chlorination of alkane. So, instead of Cl2, if you have Br2, then RBr. Similarly, if you have I2, then you will be Ri, alkyl iodide you will be getting. So, in the place of R, if you have CH3, then you will be getting CH3H, that is nothing but CH4. This is what we call it as methane. On treatment with chlorine, in the presence of sunlight or heat, there is a removal of hydrogen chloride and you will be getting CH3Cl. This is nothing but methyl chloride and hydrogen chloride you will be getting. So, this is the chlorination reaction. So, generally we call it as halogenation reaction. Exhaustive chlorination. You take methane on treatment with chlorine. Hydrogen is removed and substituted with chlorine. So, you will be getting CH3Cl, methyl chloride and hydrogen chloride. Since chlorine is taken in excess, this methyl chloride treated with chlorine, excess of chlorine. So, there is a removal of hydrogen from this carbon and that hydrogen is substituted with chlorine. So, chlorine gets substituted in the place of hydrogen. So, you will be getting CH2Cl2. CH3 will become CH2. Then, one chlorine gets substituted, so Cl2. And hydrogen combines with chlorine to form hydrogen chloride. So, you are getting methylene chloride. And this methylene chloride gets treated with excess of chlorine. Since we have chlorine in excess, so it gets treated with chlorine, excess of chlorine. So, one more hydrogen is removed from here. So, CH2, you have one hydrogen is removed and gets substituted with chlorine. So, you will be getting CHCl3. So, CH2 will become CH and one Cl2 will become Cl3 because it gets substituted with chlorine. So, Cl3. So, you are getting CHCl3 which we call it as chloroform. And this chloroform untreated with excess of chlorine. So, you will be getting CCl4 because one more hydrogen which is present here that is also removed and gets substituted with chlorine. So, you are getting CCl4, carbon tetrachloride. So, in methane, we have 4 hydrogen atoms. All the 4 hydrogen atoms are removed and substituted with chlorine. So, you are getting carbon tetrachloride. So, it's a chain reaction. It follows through free radical mechanism. So, I have discussed this free radical mechanism in the earlier videos. I will give the link in the description box. You go through it. In the free radical mechanism, we can control the chain reaction at any stage. Even you can stop at methyl chloride or methylene chloride or chloroform or carbon chloroform, etc. What you have to do is, since there is a formation of free radical, you have to stop the formation of free radical. That is, you have to remove the free radical so that the chain will not be propagated. It gets terminated. So, we can control this chain reaction, one by removing the free radicals, or you can do like this. That is, you take methane on treatment with chlorine, there is a in the presence of UV light, there is a removal of hydrogen chloride and you will be getting methyl chloride. What you can do is, you can take this as an excess, that is methane in excess you take, and then this chlorine in limited amount you take, then you can stop the reaction at this methyl chloride, that you can do. So this is how you can control or remove the free radical so that you can control the reaction. Next we have isomerization of alkanes. What does isomerization mean? It's a chemical process in which a compound is transformed to any of its isomeric forms. You take N alkane, it's a normal alkane, it is converted to its isomer. So isomers are the compounds, they have the same chemical formula but different structural formula. For example, you take N butane, this is a normal butane, it is converted to isobutane. Isobutane is converted to neobutane. All are having the same molecular formula but they will have different structural formula. So this is what we call it as isomers. And here in isomerization, why N-butane is converted to isobutane, isobutane is converted to neobutane. So likewise they will convert into one form to another form. So we can say simply, it's a process in which one isomer is converted to another isomer. For example, you take this compound CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3, 4 carbon atoms, a straight chain, so it is N-butane. On treatment with aluminium trichloride and concentrated HCl at 298 Kelvin, it is converted to this compound. That is, you have 3 carbon atoms in the straight chain and 1 carbon in the branch. So you have totally 4 carbon atoms, the same molecular formula, that is C4H10. Here also you have C4H10. So same molecular formula but you have different structure. So here you have a branch, here it's not a branch, there is a straight chain. So this is what we call it as the isomer of this N-alkane. So here this one is called as isobutane. So N-butane is converted to isobutane on treatment with aluminium trichloride and ConHCl. So this aluminium trichloride and ConHCl is a specific reagent we have used for isomerization. Here the aluminium chloride is Lewis acid and concentrated HCl is the strong acid, and this combination is used in isomerization of alkanes. So you take an example, CH3, CH2, 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 CH3, 6 carbon atoms, a straight chain. It is called as N-hexane. On treatment with aluminium trichloride and ConHCl, you will be getting one compound where you have 5 carbons in the straight chain and 1 carbon in the branch, that is side chain. One CH3 is attached to the second carbon atom. You will be getting another compound where you have 5 carbon atoms in the straight chain and 1 CH3, 1 carbon atoms in the third carbon. So this N-alkane, that is N-hexane, a straight chain, is converted to 2 compounds. In one compound, in the second carbon atom, methyl group is attached. That is what we call it as 2-methylpentane. In this another one compound where third carbon CH3 group is attached. So it is called as 3-methylpentane. So a straight chain N-hexane is converted to 2 compounds, 2 isomer. One is 2-methylpentane, another one is 3-methylpentane. So these are the position isomers and these are the isomers of this N-hexane. So this is about isomerization of alkane. Next we have aromatization. Aromatization is the process in which there is a conversion of aliphatic compound into aromatic compound. You take alkanes, alkane gender formula CnH2n+2, where n is the number of carbon atoms. If the number of carbon atom is 6 or greater than 6, aromatization will take place. The first aromatic compound is benzene. It has 6 carbon atoms. Now, this alkanes having 6 to 10 carbon atoms, they will be converted to benzene and their derivatives at high temperature and in the presence of a catalyst. That is what we call it as aromatization. Here in aromatization, the aliphatic is converted to aromatic compound. It's a very useful reaction. You take this example, that is this one, 6 carbon atoms we have. So this is what we call it as N-hexane. So instead of writing in the straight chain like this, I have written in the form of this one. So this on treatment with chromic oxide or aluminium oxide in the at 873 Kelvin, there is a removal of hydrogen from this carbon and from this carbon. So there is a removal of H2. So you will be getting a compound like this. So this CH3, instead of CH3, it will be CH2. Here, instead of here CH3, it will be CH2. And there is a bond formation between these two. So you are getting this compound, which we call it as cyclohexane. So N-hexane is converted to cyclohexane on treatment with chromic oxide and aluminium oxide on heating. And this cyclohexane has 6 carbon atoms. From 6 carbon atoms, you remove 1 hydrogen. So totally you have 1 hydrogen you have to remove from all 6 carbon atoms. So totally you have to remove 6 hydrogen atom. So on heating, there is a removal of hydrogen gas. So you will be getting benzene. So in each place you will have CH. Instead of CH2, you will have CH. So you will be getting a benzene, which is a resonance stabilized. And this is what we call it as aromatization. So we have completed the chemical properties.